That tonight is your night. Open your Bible, we read one verse. Mark 10. If we read from verse 17.
Mark 10:17.
Mark 10. From verse 17.
Retome mola 17.
Are you ready?
Amen. If it is.
He said, as he was going forth into the way, there ran one to him and kneeled to him and asked him, good teacher, what shall I do that I may inherit eternal life? And Jesus said unto him, why callest thou me good? None is good save one, even God. Thou knowest the commandments. Do not kill. Do not commit adultery. Do not steal. Whatever, whatever. And 20 says, and he said unto him, teacher, all these things I have observed from my youth. And Jesus, looking upon him, loved him and said unto him, one thing thou lackest, go sell whatsoever thou hast and give to the poor, and thou shalt have treasure in heaven, and come and follow me. Look at verse 22, but his countenance fell at the saying. He went away sorrowful, for he was one that had great possession. Can you see that? Huh? Can you see that verse? You can read until
27.
Let's pray, Father. Thank you for your word. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You know, I was just hearing this that I want to share with you. Always when God look at us, He want to address where we lack. This is God who sees us. I want to preach this message because of my Father in the Lord. I found that if God sees you, He addressed the
lack.
If you can read here, I want to tell you that you can find this man that came strongly to Jesus. When he came there, the Bible says, though he knew his pride, he knew what to get from Jesus. He knelt before Jesus. The Bible says, after he knelt, he said, what is it that I can do to inherit the kingdom? There is something that you need to learn from this man. Jesus showed him what he knew. And he said, there were things you were doing. Jesus, when he spoke with him, he was not saying he can't do what he was doing. He said, you were following the commandments. And the Bible says, yes, he did follow the commandments. But look what happened to him. The commandments made him to be very rich. But there was still something that was lacking. When he came to Jesus, he said,
good teacher.
He said, good teacher, Jesus said, I'm not good because I'm lacking you. Jesus said, I'm not good because I'm lacking
you.
He said, don't call somebody good because everybody is lacking.
He said, don't call somebody good because everybody's lacking.
I also call Father good because
he
lacks nothing. Don't call me good because I'm lacking you. When I read there, I found that the Bible says, Jesus said, go and sell everything you have and come and follow
me.
We read something so special there. The Bible says, Jesus looked on him and he loved him. I want to tell you that we are serving God who sees us. This is the topic that I want to give it to you. When God looks at you, he addresses where you are lacking. When Jesus loved the man, he saw where he was lacking. And he began to understand that the riches he got by following the commandments make his soul to be lost. And he
says,
it's better he can lose everything and come and follow me. That's what Jesus was saying. It's better you lose everything because you are lacking eternal life. If you read verse 22, the Bible says his countenance fell at the saying. I was so shocked when I was reading here. The countenance fell on the same. The reason why he was saying, the rich man was not even looking on him. He checked only the words he was told. But he didn't know why Jesus was saying that. Jesus said, you rather lose all so that you don't lack anything. Because you can seek the kingdom, all can follow. That you seek all and you lose your soul. When his countenance fell, the Bible shows he was worrying about the saying, not by the reason of the saying. Jesus understood that the reason of the saying was more than the material he was having. If you can read going down, you find even the disciples. The disciples were worrying about that. Because when they were following Jesus, they said they had properties, but they left it aside. But behind their back, they were thinking about following Jesus. They will recover more materials. But Jesus showed them that it's not good to worry about what you are lacking. It's good to worry about the one who's seeing you. Because he who sees you, he provides by the time you want. And he knows why he's providing. When he bless you, he knows why he's blessing you. We serve God that sees us. Today, you must know that God is looking on you. And he will address where you are lacking. The whole Bible, when you read, you find God addressing where people are lacking. The Bible says, this man went away He went away with his riches. But he went away from the one who sees him. There are so many people tonight that they've got properties and everything. But they are going away from the one who sees them. We serve God who sees us. I serve the Lord who sees me. You are here today and the Lord is looking on you. When he loves you, he will affect the things which are not supposed to be affected, so that he addresses where you are lacking. I've read in Genesis 21, especially from verse 14, I found a person called Hagar. And the Bible says, Hagar was in the house of Abraham. And to be in the house of Abraham, you are destined to be blessed. But the Bible says, she conceived a child that makes her to be affected by character. The Bible says, she received what was needed in Abraham's house. She received what was being said. When she found that she had got something, she began to change her character. She began to live the life of outside of the house of Abraham. And when Sarah was complaining, God heard the cry. But because she was coming from the house of Abraham, God took a decision and said, Hagar must be chased out. When she was chased out, the Bible says she went home outside with the boat full of water. She had enough when she went out. But in the process of moving, the water was finished. And the Bible says, she put her son aside and the boy was crying. But God was watching because she was in the house of Abraham. She was chased from the house of Abraham. But still she was a child who are destined to be blessed in the house of Abraham. But when she was outside there, when the child was crying because of lack of water, when the lady was also worrying about the situation, the Bible says, God sent an angel because he was watching. Tonight God will send the angel because your situation has been troubling God. Already people have rejected you, or you have been chased from your community, but you are not chased from the eyes of the living God, because he's looking on you. Tonight is your night that he can affect your affections and change your situation. If you believe, shout hallelujah. There are some people who are here. They went out full, but now they are empty. And when people look around them, they cannot associate with anybody. But God is still looking on them. Though they have been chased, we serve God that sees you. He's looking on you when you are crying. He's looking on you when you are rejected. He's looking on you when they are fighting you. He's looking on you when people are opposing you. We serve God that sees you. Tonight, he will change your situation. And if you believe, shout hallelujah. You might have finished with everything, but God who sees you, He knows where you are lacking. He wants to minister to you where you are lacking. Listen, you don't need to cry on what you are facing, because God is aware of your situation. When we read John chapter 5 verse 6, the Bible says there was a man sleeping in one place and he was invalid man. And the Bible says when Jesus came there, he sees where he was sleeping and he has learned what has happened to the man. That is long time he has been there. When Jesus come to you, he check your situation and what you are facing and your stagnations, so that he can minister to what you are facing. Even tonight, I can see God working in your life tonight. If you believe, shout hallelujah. Jesus look where the man slept. He learned that it is long time he has been there. But this could not stop Jesus. He addressed. He said to the man, do you want to be whole? Do you want to be whole? Because he knew that this man has been searching for something. Our Lord loves us to look unto him. And when we look unto him, we are perfected. We are bound to be perfected tonight. I can see God raising someone. If you believe, shout hallelujah. I say, I serve God who sees me. Tell somebody, say, hey, I serve God who sees me. You might be laughing at me, but you don't know that God is looking on the faithful. His eyes are on the faithful. I serve God who sees me. Listen to me, you can stop crying because of what you are facing, because God is aware of what you are facing. The trouble of you tonight need you to know that God is aware of your situation. Jesus is aware. That's why he went to the cross. Tell somebody, say, hey, I serve God who sees me. Can you shake that person? Say, I serve God who sees me. If you understand that, you will laugh at your opposers. You will sense healing on your pains. When people are saying you are rejected, you will feel yourself as a celebrity, because you have got heaven on your side. There are some people who are here. God says, I must come this time to address you. He's aware of your situation. He was looking at you. In your trouble, he's aware. Don't judge a Christian by what they are facing. Don't judge people by what they are facing. You are making a mistake. God is looking on his people. He's looking on me. He's looking on you. He's looking on that one. He's looking. He can look. He can see the answer where there is no answer. He can see solution where there is a problem. He can see healing where there is pain. We serve God that sees us. There is somebody I'm seeing that God is healing. I want somebody who's sick to rise up and stand right now. I want somebody that is somebody that God is healing. He has been looking on you with the pain you are facing. You have been searching for a job and people are speaking nonsense around you. But hey! I say, hey! I say, hey! I say, hey! We serve God, that sees us. Check somebody and say, hey! You were judging me, you were wrong, because you don't know whom I'm serving. You were fighting me, you were wrong. You don't know whom I'm serving. I serve God who sees me. You don't know what is happening here. There are angels here.
They are looking on you. They are looking at your disappointment. They are looking at your shame. They are looking at what you are facing. Tonight is your night. And this night, you are receiving something from above. And the devil is in trouble because you are here tonight. I see victory becoming your portion. I see success becoming your life. I serve God who sees me. I serve God who sees me. I serve God who sees me. I serve God. He's looking on me when I'm preaching in Cabroni Stadium. And he said, my son, I'm looking on everyone. And I will provide. I will provide. I will provide. I see success. It's coming to you in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus.
Yeah, I say, you know, when God wants to do things, if he can do to me, he can do to you. Some people were looking at you, but they didn't know that also the eyes of God are changing you to be something. And some people are just looking at your limitation, your studies, the books you have studied, and they are judging you because they know where you were born and where you come from. But God is raising someone tonight without a better background. He's raising you. If you believe, shout.
Hallelujah.
Are you ready to receive? Are you ready? Remember, I was talking with the people who are sick. God was looking on you. Do you want to see he was looking on us? Do you want to see that?
Amen.
Are you sure you want to see that? Remember, we are here to bless you. Whoever cannot walk there, rise up and walk now. Praying for them. Rise up, rise up, rise up. Rise up, rise up. Rise up. Rise up.
Hallelujah. Mama Shule, washiana.
She's walking.
She's running.
Hey, I say, even you can walk, rise up and walk. I see some people walking. I see people walking. If you are using crunches, lift your crunches and walk. Rise up from your wheelchair. Rise up and walk. Rise up and walk. Watch, watch, watch. Watch, watch, watch. Is it that she was using? Let's bring her out and see. I'm seeing another one there. I'm seeing another one walking there. We serve God that sees us. He's aware of our problems. My God, my God, my God, my God. Can I have mics with my pastors there? Because I want to know who's walking there. Oh, Jesus, Jesus. I'm seeing another one there. Watch there. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Jesus. I'm seeing another one here.
Papa,
hey, leave him. Leave him. He's here. Leave him. Leave him. Walk, walk, walk. Walk. Rise up and appreciate God.
God.
We serve God. Who sees us? We serve God. Baba, walk. Walk, walk. Walk, you are healed. Leave him now. Leave him now to walk by himself. He won't fall. He won't fall. Baba, walk. Let me see on the other side. Look how many crunches there. Look how many crunches that side. Look at the crunches that side. What is happening there? Try to find out there. Something is happening. I'm seeing another one here. Those who cannot walk, rise up and walk. I'm seeing that mama running.
Oh, Jesus.
Can I hear you, pastors, there?
What is happening?
She says that she's been using this crutch since 2010. Since
2010, Babere Kisai Kotai.
Now she can walk without it. Let her walk. Let us see when she's walking. She's walking. Let's get another one. We are seeing another one of two things there. Let's get somebody down. Another one.
Thank you, Jesus.
There are many. There are many you can see there. And they are completely healed. Can I hear the one? Can I get another pastor there? Who's another one? I'm seeing another one walking there. Walking there. There is nobody there.
She had arthritis for 6 years.
For 6 years?
Yes, sir. Now she's no longer feeling pains in her body and she can walk without a crutch.
She can walk. Let's get another one. Let us not dwell on one person. There are many. God is still healing people. There are many. Let's get another one. Let's hear what happened to Baba.
More than 20 years, this man was afflicted by sugar diabetes and high blood. He could not walk. They took him to doctors. They gave him medication that could not help him.
Yes.
But today he came here and the power of the living God fell upon him and he is healed.
Hallelujah.
He can stand up and walk.
Amen.
He
can walk.
Who came with him?
He came with Baba.
He could not walk, Baba.
He could not walk, man of God.
It's the first time you are seeing him like this.
It's the first time I'm seeing him like this.
We are saving God who sees us. We are saving God who sees us. Can I get another one, that sir?
There is a woman here. Said she's been having arthritis. She could not walk since 2002.
Where?
The moment you said everybody stood, stand up.
She stood up and she can walk.
She's still amazing.
She's amazing. How do you feel, Mama?
How do you feel, Mama?
You know what? When I was sitting there, when he was preaching, I felt a severe pain on my knee.
Yes.
I
can do
severe pain.
Everybody who doesn't know, who is not able to walk,
Where is your sister? Let's hear from your sister. You can't stand for a long time. Where is the sister? Can we hear from the sister? She could not walk.
She couldn't walk.
We thank God because we are hearing from the second person. She could not walk, Mama. There is a great anointing in this place. The yokes are broken. Can I get another one? The last one.
There is a woman here who said she has been affected with cervix cancer. For the past 5 months, she was bedridden. At night, for the first time in 5 months, she can actually stand up and walk on her own.
Nana le cervix cancer, me ngwedi ke thano, na sa khono emelela le khono emeletse shule.
Where is she? Let me see her.
The lady in white blouse.
Let her walk. Let her walk.
Samaya arma.
She's walking. She's walking.
Sepela shule wa samaya.
Watch, she's walking. She's walking. She's walking. She's walking. Can we get the last one?
She was having arthritis for more than 17 years.
17 years.
And she had a car accident that broke both her legs. She could not walk. She was using crutches.
She was using crutches.
When you commanded the power of God, she stood up and she's walking.
My God, oh. My God, oh. My God, oh. Can you just appreciate God? No one touched them except Jesus. I say no one touched them. Where is she? Where is she, Ducha?
Yes, she is dead.
She was using what there?
Two crutches. From car accident that broke her two legs.
Her legs were broken.
Yes, dead.
Can I see her when she's walking? Oh, my God. Another one. Let me hear.
Papa.
Yes.
We have miracles over here.
There's a miracle there.
We have this mama.
Uh-huh.
For 3 years.
14
after
years.
She gave birth.
Uh-huh.
She was paralyzed.
She was paralyzed.
She could not walk. And she went to the doctor. they operate, but it resulted to zero. But today, by the power of God, she's here walking right.
Give glory to Jesus.
Glory to God.
Let me see her walking. Let me see her walking. Where is she? She was paralyzed.
Yes, Papa.
My God, look what she was using. We serve God that sees us. Everybody here must get a miracle. HIV must go right now, right now. Diabetes must leave you right now. Heart condition must go right now. Any disease must leave you right now. Anointing must come upon you right now. Let me hear you.
Papa, we have my brother. For 5 years, he could not hear. His ears were blocked.
My God.
Today, when you declare healing, he healed.
Jesus. Can we test him? Speak with him.
I spoke with him, Papa. He was answering me.
Ask his name.
Say, what is your name? What's your name?
He can hear.
He can hear, Papa.
How long he was not hearing?
How long hearing,
sir? After the accident, then I happened to have some hearing problems.
It was after, and he encountered this problem.
I could not hear.
He's healed.
He said, "What happened to him when?"
There's still ringing sounds in the other ear.
He said he could hear sounds only ringing.
Now he can hear clear.
Yes, Papa.
He's healed forever.
Glory to Jesus.
The last one. Let's take the last one because we don't want to dwell on that.
Danny, there's another one here, Mama, who was broken. The leg was broken in 1989. As you were preaching, declaring that everyone who is using the crunch must stand up. She stood up. Now she's no longer using the crunch. In 2011, she was bitten by a scorpion, but now she can run. As you can see her here, the old lady. Walk, Mama, and show them.
Let her walk.
She was, glory be to God.
She was using what there? I can't see her. She was using what?
She was using the crunch,
but
now she can walk on her own without the crunch.
My God, my God, my God. My God.
Hallelujah.
There are many. There are many making a line there. There are
Amen.
Many. All right. Can we hear another one?
Another miracle here, Daddy.
Uh-huh.
Mama here, she said she was bitten by stroke and she could not walk. She had arthritis and she had womb cancer, which doctors wanted to remove the womb.
When Pastor.
You and you said the power of God is healing people.
Can you stop there? I want to hear what she's saying herself. Let her speak. She say what?
It's a cancer, Apopelo, last year. What is the Gadi? 2013. A baby and Tabar Honale, Solon and Mopopelo Yamaja. I got a libel. I got a tagali bell. 2014. 2015. Even Tabar Homo, Hola Mopopelo Yam. Yeah, the son came at the deity, had to get a bunch of popelo, Momarina. Can that direct his Momangueling in circa 2014?
So,
a lay stroke since I got 29 December. Can you tell me some cards?
Listen to this. I wanted you to hear from her. It's too much. It's not only what Pastor is saying. These are too much disease, but Mama, you are declared free today. Can I get that one with Costa? Let me hear.
Papa.
Yes.
This Mama, 5 years back, she was walking from the mall and she fell down ever since that day. She was paralyzed. She could not walk by herself. She was given this artificial leg and Chinese shoe to support herself.
Yes.
Today, she is healed. She removed the leg. She's walking by herself.
My God, oh! Yeah! Let me see her walking. She's the one that is walking. You are healed. You are healed. You are healed forever. God bless
thank
you.
Thank you, Jesus.
Can we get the last one? I was just saying the last one. There are many, they make line there. Can we just get one person, last one? Because I'm also hearing that there are people who cannot hear. Their ears are open. Their eyes are open. If you are blind, your eyes are open right now. Receive your miracle. Receive your miracle. Receive your miracle. Receive your miracle. Listen, after attending this service this night, you must go to the doctor on Monday and check yourself, or tomorrow. You will find that the disease is gone. That disease is afraid. It's afraid of you now. Because he who's unto you is greater than the one unto the world. Something is happening to you right now. It's happening to you. Receive your heart desire. Can you just lift up your hands and begin to thank God for what you are here for? Thank God for what you are here for. Thank God for what you are here for. I can't hear you. Is there anyone there?
Yes, Daddy, there is a woman here who said in 2014, she went to the doctor and they told her that she has brain lesion, which led to her paralysis. She couldn't walk, she couldn't hear. But today, after you declared them free, she can now hear and she can now walk for the first time since 2014.
My God. Let's taste that. Let's taste that. If she can hear. Can you speak with her?
Mama? Mama? Who is Rachel?
Since 2014. Since January 2014.
She can hear.
The brain lesion. You know, the brain lesion is a bagora gore. Who did I have a gore? Give me a gore, Paul, like a horse. I'm a. Can't attack a real with the terrible sort of stroke. Literally stroke, Carlo, Torres, Amai, Haiku, Crescent, Tabun, Seven, Kenda, Hella, Casalacasi, Ditch. Me, for now, Ibrahim Tokanyan as compared.
So you can hear herself now. Because I didn't want you people to say, we are talking for them. There's a problem here. There are sickness, there are problems, there are challenges. But thank God for their lives. You are healed. You are blessed tonight.
Amen.
Thank you. I think you can come back because we are going to another level. We are just going to another level. Are you ready for it? Can you just ask God and receive also same time, thanking God of what you are receiving by prayer? Prayer. I can't hear you. Can you just thank God for your miracle, your healing? Thank God you can hear how far. Mama, how far God is helping his people. I can't hear you, please. As you are praying, something is happening. Eh? Pray for the last time. Pray for the last time. In Jesus' name. Listen to this. We are here just to bless you. We know many people are coming to us, but coming to you, we believe it's God who come to you. It's not us. So I believe even if you ask anything, 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 it will happen to you right now. Anything, 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 anything. Listen to the second group that I want God to touch. Is those who want children. It's those who want children. They are here. God show me many people who want children. God is touching you people. God is touching you. You want children. God is touching you. Can you lift up your hands? Because I will see them when God is touching them. I will see them. I will see them.
Lift up your hands. Some of you have got fibroid. Doctor told you many things. But God is touching you now. Now, wherever you are, God is touching you. I see fire entering your stomach. You are operated right now wherever you are. You are receiving operation right now. God is touching you. That demon that has blocked your womb, that demon that has blocked you is leaving you right now. As I'm speaking here, something is happening to you there. I see twins now. As I'm speaking right now, I see twins now to you. Let me see all of them. Holy Ghost, bless them. Touch them. I say you cannot just wed and you remain empty. God is honoring your marriage. Right now, the baby is coming. The baby is coming. The baby is coming. The baby is coming. Holy Ghost, can I see them? Can I see them? I remove what is blocking your tubes right now. I remove that thing. Come out. Come out. These are the people that will give you a testimony that I've got twins without trace before. These are the people here. Come out wherever you are. Come on. People tell you that you are supposed to divorce because you are failing. Brother, wherever you are, low sperm count is going. Fibroid is going. Come on! Listen, we are here to bless you. I see fire entering you there. Where you are standing, you are supposed to receive something. That demon that was blocking you for years is leaving you. 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 Come out. Come out. Don't touch her. Leave her. Come out. Come out. Watch there. My God. The demon that was blocking you so that you must not get a child is defeated right now. I say it's defeated right now. It's defeated right now. It's defeated right now. It's defeated right now. People are laughing at you. It's over. They will never laugh at you. I say they will never laugh at you. Receive your boy. Receive your boy. Receive your boy. Your girl. Receive your girl. Receive your twins. What are you receiving?
Amen.
And God is telling me about people who have been blocked here in Botswana. Others, they cannot even afford life here in Botswana. Others are working, but their job is giving them nothing. They are struggling here in Botswana. But I'm here to tell you that, hey, it's over, it's over. I say it's over. No more struggle. No more underpaid. I say no more underpaid. There are some people who are here right now. You are working. But there is nothing. I want Holy Ghost to visit you. Some of you are not even getting jobs. You have got qualification. I command that witchcraft to leave you. Hey, hey, wherever you are. I say you are located. You are located. You are located. You are located. You are located.
I see people receiving better jobs. I say better jobs. I say business, business. Tenders, tenders. No more suffering. No more suffering. You are the second group I'm praying for. I see increase where you are working. I see a higher position where you are working. If you believe, say hallelujah. Holy Ghost, can you touch such people?
Amen.
Let me see them in the hall. Even those who are on the grandstand there. In that grandstand there, fire is coming to you there. It's coming to you there. No more interview. Just get a job. No more interview. Get a job. No more interview. Get a job. Get a job. I'm coming to you. I'm coming to you. You won't escape tonight.
Today,
I'm coming to you. I'm coming to you. Father, can you show me these people that must get a job this month? This month.
Amen.
Not next month, this month. This month, show me, touch them wherever they are. Can you touch them? Just touch them. You are seeing them. Touch them. Touch them. Let me hear them. Let me hear them. They've been struggling. They've been suffering. The demon that was blocking them, the witchcraft that was fighting them. I'm seeing it now. It's broken. It's broken. It's broken. It's broken. It's broken. It's broken. Whoever is witched and is here, you are overcoming those witchcraft. I say you are overcoming it right now. You can see what God is doing. We are just starting. There are still many as I'm looking. I'm still. The spirits that has attacked them can attack your blessing. If we don't arrest them first, if we don't arrest, they can attack your blessing. Any Satanism, wherever you are, witchcraft, any spirit of Satan is arrested. It's arrested right now. It's arrested. No one will be able to block your miracle. Whoever is witched right now, as I'm speaking, if they've witched you so that you must not progress, I want you to go home tomorrow. You write what you want to see, it will happen. You will see it in the name of Jesus. Those who have witched you, they are in trouble. I say, arise. I say, I raise it to them. I say, I raise it to them. I say, I raise it to them. When I'm walking here, I heard that there's one of the pastor here who lost his wife. And I want that pastor to come because and after you lose your wife, you marry another one. I want you to come forth. Don't be afraid. Come. I want to bless you.
I want to tell you why you lost your wife. If I tell you why you lost your wife, you won't worry again. God told me you are still worrying even now. Though you marry, but even now, when you remember your wife, you say, why? You ask yourself many questions. And you say, but why? I've been praying, I've been faithful. Why this thing happened to me? You say, even now, it's like you can just try to say, God, tell me now what. Because you have been prayerful, but now you are empty. It's not true. God said, I must tell you, He has called you. Where are you pastoring?
I'm from South Africa right now.
You are from South Africa?
Yes.
I want to tell you that God is healing the wound in your heart. And He will establish your ministry. When I lift my hand, you will receive. Receive that healing. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Take it. You are free. You are free, sir. You are free. You are free. You know, I could not address you. Your case is pathetic, but God has healed your heart. It's over. Don't worry. And when I was looking at you, when I was looking at him, I'm not saying, where is your wife?
She passed away also.
She also passed away. Can you hear that? So, can you see the issue? He had a wife, the wife died. He had another one, the one died. And now he's afraid too. And he's asking about the first one. What happened? So,
that's true, man of God.
So now, you don't have a wife now?
Right now, I don't have.
What about this one?
This one? We only sent parents to meet about two.
It's not like your wife. I heard you're afraid even for her. Don't be afraid. It's over. Take your wife, nothing will happen to you. This lady also, she have got a serious problem. You know, she's also afraid to lose you because of what has happened before. So God is helping you. You are going to marry and finish your stay together. No one will die in this family. Why were you afraid?
Why no Chavasis?
People around me have been dying.
Okay, yeah.
People around me, people I get close to, get sick, they die.
They die. So no one will die from now. And listen to this, if you are pastors here, you are free. If you are pastors from a place called Muchudi, just lift up your head. I want to tell you that God is raising prophets there. Come here. You are from Muchudi? You are a pastor there?
I'm from Muchudi, but I'm pastoring at Botswana.
You are pastoring where?
Botswana.
What's that? At Lobatse. Because I'm doubting you. Yeah, you, I'm doubting you very much. Where is your wife? Come. I'm really doubting your calling. Because of what is happening around you. Be careful. Be careful of these people of money. You hear me? They must not take over your ministry. Because God has raised you. If the people that I'm talking about is people who have got churches in Muchudi, God wants to raise prophets there. You hear me? You be careful because God wants to bless you. God, let me just bless you. God must use you in the name of Jesus. You are blessed. I want those people to come. You are free. Thank you. Yes, many people of Buchuri, I heard that they are suffering. Where are they? Where? You are from Buchuri?
Yeah, I'm from Buchuri.
You pastor in Buchuri? Come and shake hands with me. Let me touch you. Come. You are pastoring there?
Yeah.
Let me touch you. Come on. Come on. Yeah?
I went to Charis in November.
Yeah, come. Let me hit you. Yeah, come on.
And the man of God told me that I should open a church. And I'm on my way to open
come, the church. Come on. Let me get another one. Come, you people. You are free, come. Another one. Muchuru, come. Listen, we'll pray for all of you. Don't worry. You're from Muchuri?
Yes, I'm from Muchuri.
Where is your husband?
My husband is sitting at the back there.
Why is he sitting at the back there? Does he believe we are here?
He does.
Eh?
He does.
You must stand with your husband, eh?
Amen.
Eh?
Amen.
Because if you stand with your husband, you will make it.
Amen.
Come on, you demon. You're a pastor from Muchuri? Come on. Another one. You're a pastor from Muchuri?
Yeah.
Let me know, pray for you today.
Amen.
Eh?
Amen.
Because God has honored you. Okay. Another one?
Muchuri.
Okay. Baba, receive you people, your others, yeah, your parents. So the one that I'm praying for too much is you. Let me hit you again. So you're anointed. Thank you. God bless you. You must pray, you people. God loves you so much. Thank you. Hallelujah. So wherever you are, receive your heart desire. Receive what you are here for. I say, receive what you are here for.
I receive.
There are some groups I'll be praying for very soon, including my pastor there, that God wants to anoint this one. Yes. God has anointed you. God has anointed you. Come on.
Jesus.
Tonight is your night.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
I'm beginning to hear fire on top of me. Many of you, you are pastors. Lift your hands, pastors, here. Can I pray for you? If we pray for you, tonight is your night. Hey, brother, you, come here, you. Yes, congratulations, my brother. Where is your church?
In G West.
Huh? Are you not a prophet? Are you not a prophet?
That's what I'm a prophet.
Very true, sir.
Huh? You're a prophet, because I'm hearing you're a prophet.
I've been afraid to use that title.
Yeah, chavo, shumishale vichuleo.
You want to be anointed? Remember, we want to pray for everyone. Leave him here. Leave him. You leave him. Receive your own. Take it. Can you just come here? This one. What is your name?
Mbaki.
Huh? Mbaki who?
Mbaki Chigan.
Chigan?
Yes, sir.
My God. In Botswana here, people will start to talk about you.
I receive!
You know why?
No, sir.
Is it your wife?
Yes, this is my wife.
You can follow me. Don't follow me that way. Can you follow me? Hey. Leave them. Hey. What are you doing with your wife now? What are you doing here now? Why you can't stand one place?
Well, you can stay one place. Holy Spirit, thank you for anointing these people.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Leave them there. Leave them there. You are anointed.
But
pastors here, you are anointed. All of you here. Take it. Can you stand up for your own miracle? Stand up. Say, Lord, I receive my miracle.
Lord, I receive my
miracle. Can you say, I receive my miracle?
I receive my miracle.
Listen, tonight we'll pray for all of you. Don't worry.
Amen.
Don't worry. We'll pray for you. We saw one pastor that if we don't pray for him, he will ask us question if we are coming from God. You hear that? There's one pastor here. There's a lot of questions. Can you come here, sir? Yes. Originally, where do you come from?
From Mohat, Rubiro area.
Huh?
Rubiro area, Mohat.
So if I don't pray for you, you'll say God didn't send us here. Because you are questioning, you are worried, and you are very sick, sir.
Yeah.
Huh?
Yes, sir.
You are very sick because I cannot express explain your sickness here in front of children. Satan has cut you down.
Satan will repeal.
But after this, whatever that you have lost will be coming back to you.
Amen.
I saw what happened here before. Because I'm just hearing Kenya. And I was just hearing that there are some people who came here and tried to do funny things here from Kenya. Has affected many people who are called here. But thank God you are still alive, you.
Yes.
As I'm touching you now, you are free.
Thank you, sir.
You are healed forever. You can go for a test. Mama, you are free. Eh?
Hallelujah.
Satan has blocked your womb. Come. I said Satan has blocked your womb. You always feel pains. Yeah. Okay, yeah.
It's
eh?
True.
Did you go to the doctor for this?
Yes, I did.
Eh?
Yes.
So God is healing you now.
Thank you, Jesus.
Where is your husband? You please pray together.
Amen.
Because of your generational case. Amen. You know in your family what is happening in your family.
Amen.
They don't worship God.
Yeah.
Amen.
And you people, you are starting another journey of worshiping God. You must break this case.
Amen.
Eh?
It's true.
Eh?
It's true, man of God. It's true.
Okay, yeah. What is true? Can you explain?
In this family, they're not following God. When they become Christians, they just quit on the way.
Yeah. There is more than that.
Yeah.
That's
true, man of God.
There's more than that. God loves you. He's setting you free.
Thank you.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
And the whole family will be saved. There's a brother who's wearing something like a red there that God is honoring there because of suffering. Yes, God is honoring you, brother. Who came with that brother? Devil want to kill that brother. Devil want to kill him there. Who came with him? I can't hear.
My brother.
You know?
I can't
hear.
He came with her sister.
Daddy, he say his younger brother, he came with him.
He came with him.
Yes.
That man is a serious sick. Never want to kill him because even his mind is changed.
Yes.
It's like he's a mental disturb.
Yes.
Is he crazy?
Yes.
God is healing that man. God is healing him. There's a lady there. There's also a lady there that is lifting up her hand. Yes, my sister, congratulations. God is honoring you. You came here with faith, and God is blessing you.
Thank you, Lord. Yes, 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 yes.
Listen, I saw something like a land. I saw a land, and I saw property inside. And when I asked God, God says to me, there was a problem. Where is your husband?
Francis Town.
Please, you people must not fight. God is honoring you people.
Thank you, Lord.
Because you have been fighting, but I see property that is coming to you. And then you are going to be successful this year, not next year, this year.
I say
this year.
Yes.
This year is your year.
Thank you, Lord.
There's another one. This side there who's wearing white there and bokat there. Yes. That lady there. Yes. Be careful on her right side. She doesn't feel good. And this is something that has been happening in the family, like a stroke. And herself now, she's always afraid. Even the dream she's dreaming is shocking. On your right side, can you tell me about your right side?
I'm always feeling a pain.
Huh?
I'm always feeling a pain.
On your right side here?
Yeah.
So this is a stroke that is starting. It's cancelled right now. As I'm walking here, it's cancelled. It's cancelled here. There's a lady on the grandstand that God is promoting her with business. I see a tender there.
There's a tender.
On top there. Yes, there. Yeah, you. Yes, you are waving that paper. It's a tender. You want tender. God gave you. Run forward. Run, come here. Let her come. There's another one there on that grandstand there.
God grandstanding there.
I see a brother there that is standing, that God is honoring you with a job because of your situation. You, yes, you there. I'm pointing at you there. On top there. Receive your job. Yes.
I receive.
Can you receive your child? Take it. Where is the lady? Where is the lady of the tender? Where is the lady that I pointed there on top there?
Oh, Siolawadi tender.
Where is she? This is the lady. Come. Huh? You are doing tenders?
Tender.
You are starting.
Yeah, Tom.
Huh?
Kesale bizika tsona ke market.
Okay, all right. You are starting.
What, Tom?
So, you cannot start and win tender.
Ogas Tom, I want to win.
Let me touch you.
Rekutswa.
You are blessed.
Chofe.
My sister, you have won this tender.
Sisi we win the tender.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Can you see where you are standing? Do you know me?
No.
Leansima.
Huh?
No.
I never spoke with you before.
Yes,
and I'm just saying you win tender.
Yes,
and you know you are doing tenders.
Yes,
and you know you were failing.
Yes,
you have been struggling going up and down.
Yes,
you are going to be a proof that God was here.
I receive, man of God.
There is a woman there who is an usher there also. I see this lady who's like fed.
A fat lady. Just wave your hand like this, my sister. Even you, God has honored you. Watch that lady there. God has honored that lady also. Can you stand up? I see business everywhere. This lady, I can't see her face. My sister, I'm seeing you as a strong businesswoman. Can we hear her, pastors? Can you stand up? Can you stand up because you were far? You were far, sister. Were you not doing business?
Yes, I'm doing business, man of God.
Is it not tenders?
Yes, I'm doing tenders.
I'm seeing God touching you.
Hallelujah.
Receive. Take it. Jesus' name. There is another one at the end there. Yes, you, my brother. You are wearing blue, holding blue papers. Those blue papers, run to me. Run to me. The blue paper. Come to me. God has honored you.
Amen.
So God is here everywhere. There's a pastor here. His name is called what? Sam or Semi, something like
that.
Can you come forward
Semi
here?
Semi or Sam.
Come, Semi. They call you what? I can hear.
Sam.
Sam.
Sam. Yes.
But when you're small, they used to say, Semi.
Never say Musalmuni.
Do you know why God has called you?
What's your name?
Yes, sir.
Huh?
Yes, sir.
You are a deliverer.
Oh, Mulukolo.
You're a deliverer, but your background was not good. Because you were groomed in a poverty place.
Oh, this is your character.
Yes, sir.
And you grew up with strife and pain.
And
but because you are here today, God will prove your family wrong.
Amen.
God can still raise people like you.
Amen.
Receive it. In Jesus' name. Take it.
Amen.
Take that anointing. Receive anointing.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Where is the brother? Brother, God loves you. There are two things I'm calling you for. Is this one your wife?
Yes, sir. Yes, this is my wife, sir.
When did you marry her?
2004, sir.
2004.
2004.
Yes.
She must go and do the checking. There's a cyst on her side.
Yes, sir.
Yes, the doctors told me. I think it's
they say you have got a cyst.
Yes.
You always feel pain.
Yes. The pain is there right now.
Even now.
Really
yes. My brother, when God is honoring you, He's healing your wife too.
Yes, sir. I receive.
Give me the papers. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Father, thank you for making this man a millionaire.
Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you.
You are blessed. There's a pastor here. I'm sure this pastor visited me. Here. This pastor, I'm sure he visited me. This pastor. Come, brother. Listen to this, my brother. This one is your wife.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
I'll tell you something that will shock you. Can I tell you?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
sir.
The way God wants to use you is exactly the way God wants to use your wife.
Amen. I always tell her. I always tell her.
You tell her what?
That God wants to use us both, that we should pray and ask, trust God.
Can you say that God speaks with you?
Yes, sir.
Can you say God speaks with you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. I want to shock you by that.
No,
whatever you are hearing, it's not you. God put something in your heart. You know the reason why people were hating you here?
Yes.
Was because of what you are supposed to do here. You are going to struggle a lot. Even now, I'm still struggling.
Yes, sir.
You are still going to struggle a lot until people here in Botswana begin to know who you are. God wants you to say, there is no rain and there will be no rain. There is a rain and there will be rain. God is raising you. So, now as I'm speaking, some people will begin to understand why God has called you.
Amen.
Because many, they don't even understand. So you are trying like coming to people who don't even understand.
Yes,
huh?
Yes, sir.
So don't worry, God is honoring you from now. We are going to speak things from now, not tomorrow.
Hallelujah!
And things will happen.
Amen.
Eh?
Amen, I receive, man of God.
Are you ready for that?
Yes, sir.
Can you just speak something so that we see it tomorrow? Because God say from now.
From next week, there will be rain all over Botswana in Jesus' mighty name.
How long it was not raining?
For a very long time.
For a long time.
Yeah.
So because we came here and you spoke the words, your words will come to pass.
Hallelujah. I receive.
You are anointed. Thank you. Thank you.
I want to say to you, your testimony is following you in the name of Jesus.
Can you just receive your testimony? Can you just thank God? Can you thank God wherever you are? Thank God. Because God has done it. Can you lift your hands and thank God for the will of God upon your life, the grace of God upon your life, in the name of Jesus. Carry on. Thank God for that miracle. Thank God for healing. Thank God for success that is coming upon you, in the name of Jesus. Father, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Can you just thank God? Thank God. Thank God. Wherever you are, thank God. Can you thank God? I can't hear you. I can't hear you. Thank God for the anointing, pastors. Thank God for the anointing upon your life. Thank God for the anointing upon your life. Thank God. Thank God. Thank God. Wherever you are, we glorify you. We believe Botswana will never be the same. The testimonies that are coming will shake the foundation of Satan. We believe the grace of God is following everyone. Amen. We believe that whoever watches this is also receiving. As you are receiving, they are receiving. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. There is no more delay in your life. Success will be your portion. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Receive. Receive, receive, receive the grace, receive. You serve God that sees you. He's looking at you. He's supplying your needs. Receive in the name of Jesus. Receive your car, receive your house, receive whatever you want. What are you receiving? Mention it right now. Say it right now. Say what you are receiving. Say it right now. The grace of God is upon you. Say it. Speak louder when you are saying it. Say it. In the name of Jesus. I see you. Within a week, you'll be testifying. I say within a week, you'll be giving us a testimony. Receive. Receive. Receive in the name of Jesus. Rejoice, rejoice wherever you are. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' name.